Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened, this scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip. Yeah. Nice to see you, too. Jack's room. It's like he never... Damn it. I used to think I'd never fit in. But Jack, he didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special. Jack was part of the solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't dampen his spirit. Come on, Jack, where'd you put it? Okay, let's do this the other way. Keep hissing at me. Who do you think's gonna feed you now? Jack was a humble, religious man. He ran a funeral home, and I'd help out whenever I could. It felt good to be useful. Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To take care of them. To listen. That was the least I could do. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, "Pretty sick, huh?" I was such a dork. I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that. Yeah. I used to have a thing for him. Don't know why, really. I guess they just used to make me happy. Jack knew it well. That's why there's so many of them here. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Oh, weird. I don't remember locking it. The key should be in the office. Here it is. not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. Got your special clip? No. Where's your Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. I guess you're ready. But am I? You people read. The sign says closed. What the hell? Guess you felt it too, huh? And then it happened. As it did so many times before. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Oh, where is that darn notebook? I'm gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Oh, Marianne, are you crying, my child?
It's fine, Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully, eh? Where is that thing?
Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
No, I can't just...
Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Oh, why is it so cold in here? Where is that?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff then. Eh? All right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need... Oh. Yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that. Always.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided. Torn between two realities. But no. I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look. If this is a joke...
You need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. But I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Nebo Resort. Find me there. Please. The light, it's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit.
Thank you.
And off I went, on nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. I felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me. The Neva Workers' Resort. Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place. Anyone home? I guess not. What the? Hello? Thomas? The front gate was locked up tight. I needed to find another way in. You want to keep me out, Neva? You're gonna have to do better than that. Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort. Until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy. Crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual. Hello. What's this? Looks like an old fort. Might be my way in. Something happened here. Split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen. Dead. Like everything else in this place. Yeah, not getting through here. Not with the power out. When you exist in two realities, you're affected by either. I'd learned that the hard way. The place felt old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely, fragile, waiting for someone to embrace it. As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this world? In any case, I figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Whew. So that worked. Good for you, Marianne.
These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, they did come in handy sometimes. So there I was, existing in two worlds, but never really living in either. What the hell are you, Neva? The aura in that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions, and none of them good.
No, there's definitely something. Trust me, you made the right call sending me. Yes. It's only a matter of time.
Even the objects here had auras. When I touched them, I could sense their stories. Words, images, feelings left behind.
Hello? Anybody in there?
Locked. Obviously. There's gotta be another way. Handle's missing. Maybe I could replace it with something. Huh? Ah. I think there's a broken window up there. If only I could reach it. I sense something. Hey, old-timer. Now, what's a fine machine like you doing in a place like this? Doubling as a spare bedroom, apparently. Hope you don't mind if I, pop your trunk. Not much here. Although, this could come in handy. Ow! Shit! What the hell? So began the great dumpster heist of 1999. I'm starting to get tired of your shit, Neva. You better be worth it.
Mm-hmm.
Hello? Anyone? Thomas? You there? Hello? Thomas?
Easy, Marianne.
It's just a good old-fashioned haunted hotel. Calm your ass down and answer the bell. Startled me. Yeah,
I did, didn't I? You look real scared. I'm sadness.
Marianne. Sadness. Is that your name? I mean, you seem pretty cheerful to me.
Well, it's what I remember. My friends used to call me by a different name. But I don't remember what it was.
Your friends?
Oh, yeah. I used to have a lot of friends here. But they're all gone now.
Did something happen to them?
I don't really want to talk about it.
That's okay. So, do you live here? All by yourself?
You wouldn't believe how boring it gets sometimes.
I can imagine. This place must have been...
Oh, yes! So busy. People coming and going all the time. Always someone to play with.
Must have been nice.
It was. Not anymore.
So, tell me, what happened?
I remember. People stopped coming. Only a few of them stayed. But they became very sad. Very angry. They might hurt you.
Thanks. But I can take care of myself.
Anyway, I was wondering, have you seen...
Marianne?
Yes?
Would you play with me? Just for a little while? It's been so long since I played with anyone.
Oh, okay, okay. But I need your help first.
Yes. Yes! Anything, Marianne!
I'm looking for a man. Thomas. Do you know him?
Let me think. I've heard that name before. Somewhere.
Take your time.
Oh yeah! The second floor! We can look there! Come on! Hurry,
Marianne! Wait! I can't go that way! Damn. I need to get up there somehow. Hey. An elevator. Might as well see if it works. Sadness. I wished I knew her real name. Shit. Okay, Marianne, just take a deep breath and... let go. There, a fuse box. Need some energy to spark it up. Move fast. An out-of-body experience. It's like taking a plunge into nothingness. Stay under for too long and it just pulls you in. Get your ghostly ass back and power up that elevator. Thank you. should she go? What is that? Okay. Not getting through here. Shit. I didn't even know I could do that. Ah, gross. It looks like flesh.